Do you know that when we drive, all of our social networking skills go into the very act of driving, and that everything that we need to know about getting along with people, making eye contact, and doing all of that comes into play? So there should be no surprise at all that a lot of social networking skills are called into when we're driving, especially when you live in a city like Phoenix, where navigating the traffic becomes quite an art between the people's different skills, their distractions, and trying to connect with them through eye contact. A lot of times they make contact with you via hand signals and things like that. The lack of attention that they're paying. Sometimes they're doing their own online social networking by updating Twitter. And of course, everyone knows about the problems with people talking on cell phones and texting and that while driving. Do you also know that our social networking skills also have a great deal to do with our happiness, our personal happiness? So social networking is really connected to our happiness, and if we engage in it in very sort of stressful things like driving, public transportation, walking, in retail stores, at work, and things like that, we don't fully get the benefit of it. A couple of years ago, I did a video on online social networking, and occasionally it still gets some hits, and I do look at it every once in a while and surprise myself realizing that actually in some ways I did kind of make some sense back then, and that it is still somewhat relevant. But here's what I think about social networking today, 2010. So there's pretty good empirical evidence that the quality and the quantity of our social networking does impact our happiness, and that about 4 degrees of social networking is the maximum that most people really get some benefit out of, and that probably most people can only handle about 100 people within their social networks. That said, I'm thinking that probably with offline and online social networking, that, you know, integrating those two, that's probably the same number for both offline and online social networking together. That means to me that what we should probably be thinking about is our online social networking and integrating it with, you know, offline social networking, and the number of people and the quality and quantity of it. For me personally, I think probably about 2 to 3 degrees has the maximum impact on me, and probably less than 100 people. So I kind of really look at that with my online social networking. I know that a lot of people get, you know, a lot of satisfaction out of on Facebook having hundreds or even thousands of friends, or on LinkedIn on a professional network. That could probably, you know, be correlated maybe to the success of a business person, or depending on what kind of business they're in. Some people like to have hundreds of thousands of followers on Twitter. Again, I believe that depends upon what, you know, you're on there for, whether it's business related or it's for personal happiness.